all people of African descent all over the world unite. All the 55 states of Africa and the African states in the Caribbean unite. All the ethnic groups and tribes of Africa unite. All the leaders and people of Africa unite. We have to understand African unity and its dimensions so as to get a full hold of it and to rebuild Africa. The dimensions of African unity are those different aspects of African existence where we must unite. There are the four dimensions, four different aspects at which Africans must unite, and those four dimensions must be handled sometimes separately, sometimes jointly, but with deep understanding that they are not exactly the same and they will come at a different pace and cost. The four dimensions of African unity are: 1. The global African unity. 2. The continental unity of Africa. 3. The ethnic unity of Africans. And finally, the unity between African leaders and people. Those who know the gains of African unity know we cannot do without African unity. And those who have the understanding realize that there is no reason why Africa should not unite, because all impediments to African unity are artificial and can be fixed by sufficient understanding and wisdom. In our unity lies the rebuilding of Africa and the return of the glory of all Africans worldwide. Now let's go to the meaning of African unity. African unity, broadly defined, means Africans working together toward African progress. African unity means Africans becoming one. African unity means African cooperation, the cooperation of all African people, Africans working together as one to progress. Now, let us dissect the four dimensions of African unity one after the other. 1. Global African unity. Global African unity is the unity of all people of African descent. It is the unity of all African people all over the world. It is the global African unity that's the first dimension of African unity that gave birth to Pan-Africanism. It was the global unity of all Africans that gave rise to great stars like Edward Blyden, Marcus Garvey, Malcolm X, Evans Setima, Henry Clark, and a host of other Pan-African leaders and scholars worthy of great honor. Global African unity touches the plight of all Africans all over the world while protecting and defending Africa as the homeland of all Africans and the origin of world civilization. We must take the global unity of all Africans to greater heights by continuing in the teachings of our early Pan-African leaders, especially Marcus Garvey, who achieved so much by uniting all Africans under one umbrella, the Universal Negro Improvement Association, UNIA, with one slogan: one God, one aim, and one destiny. At his peak, he had more than 4 million active Africans in his network and had many businesses communally owned by Africans, employing Africans, example, the Black Star Line. He also popularized the African colors, the red, green, and black. Red for the blood of Africans, green for the vegetation of Africa, and black for the glory of Africa. The RUBG, which was also found in Kemet, was popularized by Marcus Garvey. And also the Black Star, which is today found in the flag of Ghana, was also brought out by Marcus Garvey. We Africans must today and forever unite globally under one umbrella. We must cooperate socially, politically, spiritually, and economically. We must unite and buy and sell within ourselves to enrich ourselves. We must educate, train, enhance, and equip ourselves to be the best. We must defend and protect the interests of all Africans without border. We must fund ourselves, help ourselves, love ourselves in every way we can. We must make sure that any attack on any African anywhere in the world would get the response from all Africans anywhere in the world. We must all work together worldwide to rebuild Mother Africa, which is our root and where lies our pride. And together, we must reclaim all our lost heritages and legacies, the world. The strongest impediments to global African unity are the colonial nationalities given to us by the imperialists. I'm a Ghanaian, I'm a Nigerian, I'm a Sierra Leonean, and so on. Whereas we all are Africans. Therefore, we must throw away the colonial borders and nationalities and accept only one African identity globally. The second impediment is religious fanaticism. So many times we respond more to our religious brothers who do not care about us, or even who suffer us the more, while neglecting our own people who would be there for us in times of need. African Muslims care more about Arabs who enslaved them for 1,000 years than for their fellow Africans. Also, African Christians are concerned with European Christians that sold us in millions than they are concerned about fellow Africans who desperately are in need of help, even more than the Europeans. we must turn from that path and put Africans first all around. That is global African unity. That is the wisdom. That is the progress. Number two, the continental unity of Africa. The second dimension in which Africa must unite is continentally. The Continental Union of Africa is the unification of all the whole of Africa, including the African countries abroad like Jamaica and Haiti, the Caribbean, into one nation, one country, one super state, under the name the United Continent of Africa, the United Africa, or the United States of Africa. This dimension of African unity was the dimension that Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, Julius Nyerere, Sheikh Anta Diop, Muammar Gaddafi, and so on emphasized the most, while also championing the global unity of Africa. The Continental Unity of Africa is a very powerful union, which when gotten will give Africa one powerful currency, instead of depending on colonial currencies like CFA, dollar, and pounds. It will give us one powerful army for African defense from internal and external threats. It will give us one powerful government that can oversee the interests of all Africans worldwide. One African continental bank, one large economy, one large market, a market of about 1.3 billion people worldwide. The African Monetary Fund to balance the African economy, and many other powerful advantages which are too numerous to mention and which Africans cannot take advantage of without unity. It will make all people of African descent have a government they can rely on worldwide to boost inter-African trade and therefore African ICT, productivity and agriculture, health, manufacturing and so on. Africans must be well informed on the many benefits that are attached to the Continental Unity of Africa, so we all can come together as leaders and people and get the one African nation into existence. No African state can rise and stand alone, but together as one united Africa, all African states shall rise as they desire and never have our backs on the ground anymore. We do not have any other country apart from the United States of Africa. What we have today are colonial countries, and they do not belong to Africa but to Europe. So we reject them. We only accept the United States of Africa with maps in Africa drawn only by Africans for Africans. Three, we have the ethnic and tribal unity of Africans. An ethnic group is a group of people having common racial, national, religious, or cultural origins, while a tribe is a group within the ethnic group. Ethnic groups have a distinct language and culture. Tribes are offshoots of ethnic groups, meaning that they could speak a dialect of an ethnic group or have a slightly different subculture of an ethnic group. For instance, Arabs are a part of an ethnic group because of a common language and distinct culture. Quora.com. Now, what does this thing mean is that ethnic groups are larger than tribes. Within an ethnic group, you have different tribes that make up the ethnic group, but the ethnic groups are the larger groups of people. Now, ethnicity in Africa. Africa has 3,000 distinct ethnic groups and about 2,000 languages. Africa is home to the most genetically diverse people on earth. So diverse that two Africans are more genetically different from each other than a Chinese and a European are from each other. Africa is the world's largest, second largest, and second most populous continent, according to the AfricanHolocaust.net. You can see how much diverse African people are, which is one of the reasons African people think it is hard to achieve African unity. Of all the dimensions of African unity, the dimension of ethnic unity is the toughest, even in all nations of the world, and it is usually the fourth line of disintegration, if not well handled, and it's usually the dimension of which riots, civil wars, and other forms of agitations are fought, and it's also the gateway through which colonizers enter to divide and conquer people. Now check it out, Nigerian Biafra War, the Rwanda Civil War. Check most of the wars in Africa, and you will likely see one ethnic group pitted against other, or one religious group against other. It is also the same issue affecting some other nations of the world that have not yet tackled it. Example, blacks and whites in America. The continental and ethnic dimensions of African unity together address the so-called xenophobia in South Africa by giving all Africans one nation and one identity. This ethnic dimension of African unity is the dimension of African unity that no leader has actually addressed like the other dimensions. We tend to wish ethnicity away, but we can't. We only have to work it out until it fades away, till we have full African unity, when all Africans identify themselves as one ethnic group, one tribe, that is, African. Now, how can we achieve ethnic unity in Africa? To achieve ethnic or tribal unity, we must first of all remove the colonial countries in Africa that have no respect for the ethnicities and tribes in Africa. The map of Africa today was drawn by the colonizers at the Berlin Conference of 1884-1885, and it has raised so much inter-ethnic conflicts in Africa. What Africa needs are ethnic states within the United States of Africa, drawn by Africans themselves. Ethnicities that agree to form states of their own can work together as members of a particular state in the United States of Africa. From 55 states, Africa would likely have about 200 states when African states are drawn according to the wishes of Africans. The ethnic states will remove the fear of domination that exists in the current colonial countries that create disharmony among Africans. 2. Let all Africans organize as one family in OAF, the One Africa Family. Let us discuss our ethnic issues and also the advantages. Let every group name their grievances and wishes. We can neutralize tribalism by asking the different ethnic groups to list what they want, how they want to achieve them, and the assistance they need, and what they will contribute to make the achievements work, so that the government would work with the ethnic groups rather than against the interests of the tribes of Africa. 3. We must promote one African identity. Ethnicity is an identity. It has a language, culture, religion, and so on. We must promote one African ethnicity by promoting one African language, common African dressings, and so on, so we can have an African identity in place of diverse identities. Next, we need common African values. For there to be unity, there must be a common value system among Africans. Ethnic unity is to be built on a common value system. A value system that places love for people first. A value system that has wisdom, truth, courage, and dignity. Every African must demand that which is just be done for every single one. We must not rob any ethnic group to give to another ethnic group. That is one of the reasons for contentions in Africa. We should not rob any ethnic group to pay the other. We must give what is just to every single one, and that will guarantee the continental unity of Africans, because the continental unity of Africa is based on the ethnic unity of Africans. Now finally, we have the unity between African leaders and people. Finally, the last dimension of African unity is the unity between African leaders and people. There is a big gap currently between African leaders and people, because the people of Africa are crying out. The leaders are rich and the people are poor. The leaders are powerful and the people are powerless. The leaders are on the side of the colonial masters while the people are yearning for freedom. The leaders make plans without the consent of the people. The people who do not know how the wealth of nations is going are crying that there is no accountability at all. The leaders are carrying out policies that do not reach to the common people. The leaders are living in the best of houses with security while millions of the African people are homeless and being killed every day. The Chinese are buying up Africa and the leaders are selling Africa out to them. People are the ones to suffer it. This is unacceptable. The people of Africa are yearning for unity, says Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, and it is true. But the leaders do not have plans for that because they are already comfortable. We want leaders that will feel our pain like Sankara and do something about it till everyone is fine. We want leaders like Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, who had burden for all the people and not for himself alone. We want to see our leaders walking freely on the streets without fear of being mobbed to death, because they know that they have nothing to fear. We want our leaders to carry us along in every program, to sacrifice for us and not to sacrifice us to colonization, hunger, and disease. We want our leaders to be humble and caring like they are during the election periods. Our leaders should not be like the colonizers who lived large, rode big cars, and lived in big houses at our expense. We expect our leaders to be different, since they are our own brothers. Only people who have the burden for leadership should be in leadership. They are the ones who would build people and build the nation. They are the ones that wouldn't build comfortably and live in gigantic palaces with steady power supply, where the people are squatting three in a room with zero power supply. The unity between African leaders and people is when, one, the leaders and people have one heart and one vision. 2. When the leaders carry the people along in all the program of the nation. 3. When the people have access to the leaders as much as the people have access to their fathers and their mothers. 4. when the leaders and people suffer the same poverty, pain and scarcity together, or better still, enjoy the riches of the nation together. 5. When the leaders work for the people using the resources of the nation. 6. When the leaders use the same roads, hospitals, schools and so on that people use, rather than flying private jets when the people trek, or being treated abroad while hospitals at home are in ruins, or send their children abroad for education while schools at home are badly substandard. Finally, it is when the leaders listen to the grievances, wishes and wills of the people they represent and act according to them. When the leaders and the people are one, the leaders can die for the people and the people can die for the leaders. The resources of Africa wouldn't develop in Europe or America or the bank accounts of African leaders, but the resources of Africa would develop Africa, and there will be justice, peace, love and progress all across the African family worldwide. And the people of Africa shall no longer be the least people on earth, but the greatest in the world. So be it. The unity between the leaders and the people of Africa must be developed as a new ground of African unity and fully attained, so that the leaders and people won't continue to move at opposite directions. Failure to unite African leaders and people would result in bloody revolution all over Africa. Finally, African unity is the cooperation of all Africans worldwide. African unity is a deep network of realities. There are 4 dimensions of African unity: global unity of Africans, continental unity of Africa, ethnic unity of Africans, and the unity between leaders and people of Africa. Pan-Africanism started with the move for the global unity of Africans. The continental unity of Africa is the unification of Africa into one nation. The ethnic unity of Africa is the dimension of African unity that no leader has yet addressed. And finally, the people of Africa and the leaders must unite to avoid a revolution. Globally, continentally, and ethnically, the leaders and people of Africa must unite.